blockchain solves the problem of trust and promises to transform the way we connect, store information, and trade. At its heart, blockchain is easy to understand. However, much of the discussion about it is more complex than it needs to be. Imagine you want to buy a secondhand car. You look online and find the perfect car. The seller of the car tells you that it was purchased 3 years ago and it has been regularly serviced. He has kept a record book and everything appears to be in order, but can you trust him? Is the record accurate or does it contain false information? Perhaps there was an accident and the required work was not recorded. Or perhaps the car has never been serviced and the seller just faked the records. Ultimately, you need to decide to trust or not trust the seller. You could do the extra work of talking to the mechanic or meeting them in person, but they may not tell you the truth. At some point, a decision about trust needs to be made. The problem of trust is not limited to buying a car. When you order from Amazon, you trust that what you order will arrive. When you use internet banking, you trust that the bank will transfer your money. When you use Uber, you trust that a safe driver will arrive. Blockchain solves the problem of trust and removes the need for middlemen of trust, such as Equifax, JP Morgan, Airbnb, Alibaba, even eBay. While it is accurate to describe blockchain as an immutable, distributed ledger that is continuously updated, this jargon is not easy to understand. So let's adjust the language. Rather than ledger, let's call it a record book, and rather than immutable, we'll say permanent, and rather than distributed, let's use the word shared. So blockchain is a permanent record book that is shared. It's not one centralized copy of the book that is shared, but rather thousands of copies that are shared on computers all around the world. Each computer has a full and complete copy of all records since the record book was created. As the record book is shared across the network, it is impossible for a false entry to be added. Consider our secondhand car again. If the history of the car was stored on a blockchain, you would have complete confidence in the data. Each record stored on the blockchain is stamped by the trusted third party that wrote that record and is secured with a unique key for that record. The key is created using cryptography and it is unhackable. New records build upon existing records, with each new key not just securing that record, but locking all previous data in a secure chain of data, a blockchain. The use of cryptography to create a secure key makes the data totally trustworthy. To hack a blockchain, an individual would need to hack the key, not just for one block, but for all the blocks on the chain since the shared record book was created, and not just on one computer, but across millions of computers simultaneously. This is infinitely more secure than how non-blockchain data is currently stored by your government or bank. Smart contracts provide even more utility to blockchains. Smart contracts allow you to set parameters to determine when, why, and how new line items are added to the record book, essentially ensuring that each party honors their commitments. For instance, a smart contract could be set up to pay the driver when you arrive at your destination, or only pay a seller after the goods arrive at your home. The genius of this shared record book is that it doesn't require a middleman to function. You do not need to place trust in JP Morgan, Amazon, Uber, or any middleman. As everyone has a copy of the record book, it's not controlled by a single person or company. Here are five real-world examples of how companies are using this technology. Blockchain technology is being used by companies like Civic to create a secure online digital identity. By combining multiple reputable sources, they are able to protect you against identity theft. Consider fair trade as well. As a company, let alone a consumer, it's very hard to have total trust in the authenticity of your supply chain. Or to say this in another way, how do you know that your Indonesian coffee is really from Indonesia? Providence is a startup using blockchain to track the entire supply chain. It's not just a transfer of goods, but also money that blockchain can be used for. Financial companies charge up to 10% to transfer money internationally, and it can take up to a week to arrive. Abra is a startup that uses blockchain technology to transfer money internationally at a fraction of the time and cost. Blockchain can also be used to create a decentralized version of P2P ride sharing networks, like Uber, but without the Uber, only riders and drivers involved. This reduces the cost of ride sharing. Startups such as Arcade City have already created this. And when it comes to cloud storage, rather than using Google, Amazon or Dropbox to store your data, companies like Storo use blockchain technology to create a cloud that is shared by the community. This provides a high level of privacy and reliability at a fraction of the cost. So blockchain technology solves the problem of trust and allows us, the people, to connect and trade directly without the use of a middleman. Blockchain provides us with the confidence of knowing who we are dealing with, having total visibility of transactions, and with smart contracts, recourse if there's a problem. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to support my channel, you can subscribe, leave a comment, share, a thumbs up, just engage with the channel. Thanks for watching.